ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we were speaking about the fame and the respect that we as a Muslim ummah have for the great messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's important for us for just in these next 2 minutes to understand how to approach him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the first of the questions that we need to ask ourselves, my dear brother and sister in Islam, if the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to pay you a visit personally, and he was to arrive at your door and be admitted to your home and spend a day with you, how would you feel and how would he feel being with you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How have you built your life? Will he recognize himself in it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Will he see himself in it? I'm not talking about clothes and beard and these things. I'm talking about your character, your belief, your aqidah, your reliance upon Allah. I'm not talking about the outward, I'm talking about the inward. Would the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam see his decisions in life in your decisions in life? Would he see that reflection of himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your home? And this, my dear brothers and sisters, is one of the most confronting questions you and I must ask ourselves regularly. Based on this question is this concept of sunnah, a modality of life. How you live your life seeks to mimic the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's easy for many of us to do it from the outward perspective. It's easy to do it outwardly. It's very difficult to do it inwardly. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Bilal, arihna biha, comfort us through salah. Do you find comfort in salah? Are you comfortable waking up for fajr? This is the example of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fil fara'id, in the major aspects of our life. So the second question that attaches to this, how can we fix ourselves to be nearer to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And that has to come through two processes, tasfiyah, cleaning the things that we have learned incorrectly about his life and other people's life, things that we do culturally that have nothing to do with Islam, and tarbiyah, putting in its place the proper teachings and the proper etiquette and the proper sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore the first thing spoken to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through Jibreel by Allah is iqra. It's not within yourself, O Muhammad. ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب. You inside you didn't know what the book. The Quran wasn't in you. No. You had to discover it. You had to learn it. You had to receive it. You had to ponder it. You had to study it. Iqra. It's not you. You're not born ready. You have to receive the knowledge and put it into practice. Al-ilm wal-amal. And that is the word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always says to us in the Quran. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. Those who believe means those who learn what to believe in. Wa amilu salihat. And those who do by what they have come to hold as is the tenet of their faith. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and I with the love of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to help us steer our life in accordance to his sunnah, and to protect our home, and to protect our families with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. Finally, my dear brothers and sisters, we remember each other in this day of heat. You know, the air conditioning goes out, we turn off the lights, we turn on the fans, and we remember each other as believers. You know, we know how we are feeling. The person next to you is giving you heat, you could feel his radiation. Inshallah, you can appreciate the difficulty that you are in. But wallahi, 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 my dear brothers and sisters, there are people who may be not seated next to you, maybe in a different city to you, maybe in a different country to you, who feel that same heat and hunger you feel. I want you to think, my dear brothers and sisters, today of the prosperity you have. You know, yesterday there's the celebrations of Australia Day. It's one of the strongest economies of the world today. I got off a plane Thursday evening from the UK. And I can tell you, it was the first time I visit the UK 5-6 times a year. It was the first time that I get out of Heathrow Airport and I see proper British citizens. I'm not talking Romanian or people, you know, beggars in the streets. I'm talking proper British people holding up signs as you're driving the highways, as you're driving the freeways, saying, I don't have a job, I need help. Can you give me something? Others saying, I never begged before, but I have to now. Help me. Others just saying, whatever you can, give me. And I'm not talking about people who look like street people or people who look like they're doing it out of mental illness. I'm talking that the world today has changed dramatically from what we have seen in the previous years. So prepare yourself through your charity towards others. Help those others so that Allah will be helpful to you. Protect your home, protect your family through sadaqah. And I leave you with this blessed example of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, said, لم أسمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لا إلا في لا إله إلا الله. I never heard Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم say لا, no, to anyone except when he said لا إله إلا الله. No God is worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our Nabi. The generosity of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you for the time that you have spent in the heat. We always seek to delay it so that those who come for the time of the salah are on time with us insha'Allah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you for your patience. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us and grant us good and success in this dunya, and to give us and grant us success in the akhirah, and to make us from those who are saved from hellfire, and to join the company and the hilaq and the circle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam near his house and in Jannatul Firdaus with the Prophets of Allah. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah, wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. Allahumma arzuqna al-birra wal-huda wa tuqa ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdibina waj'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa zid wa barik ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa habibina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة.